What's up, YouTuber? Jose Quiñones, the CNC dude here. Hey, if you are a maker trying to shoot video with your camcorder, you have probably struggled with how to position your tripod. Take, for example, when trying to shoot video on your lathe. You're trying to machine something and the tripod is probably on the frigging way. I have not been able to find a good position, which is why I almost feel like I need arm extensions just to be able to get to the friggin' tool. And to make matters worse, I can hardly see what I'm trying to do. So the tripod really doesn't work for me when trying to do anything on the lathe. Of course, at this point in time, you may feel tempted to ask, well, how about that nifty contraption you showed us a few weeks ago, where you had a magnetic base connected to a flexible arm to magnetically bolt your camcorder into the tool? Well, not so fast, because the problem is that when you magnetically couple this to the lathe, now whatever vibration the lathe suffers from transfer into the camcorder, and the footage is not good. It's awful. The same pretty much happens on any tool that is going to vibrate as you're working on whatever it is, removing material, making holes. It just doesn't work. The best way to solve that problem is to isolate the camera mount from the tool in question, which is what I'm going to show you today. However, before we go there, let me show you a secondary problem that I solved by using this technique. On my previous video, I had mentioned strapping this chunk of steel to a ladder with a ratchet strap so that I could gain some height. This worked, but of course, it is only one height. It is also really cumbersome to be continuously mounting and dismounting this chunk of steel from here. So it's not very elegant or very practical. I will tell you something though. If you're gonna follow this methodology, make sure you strap your chunk of steel to your ladder, because you don't want to be that idiot who forgets that you have something incredibly heavy on top of your ladder, and then when you leave your ladder, you may end up with that piece of incredibly heavy stuff on the top of your head. Now I know what you're thinking, who on earth would be such an idiot? Who on earth indeed? Behold my solution to both problems. It is a camera stand on wheels. Oh yeah, check it out. I can dance with this guy. Super cool, made out of steel, of course. Now I can strap my camera. Allow me to ask, do we have a letter H? And what you can do is, what an H? What are you talking about? You're so funny. No, no, no. This is not a hangman noose. How about a C as in car? Guys, I already told you it is not a hangman. Actually, yeah, there is a C. Who would have thought? Anyway, what I can do is by removing this tension on this screw, I can change the height. It's a little bit finicky, but it works. And of course, this allows me to position the camera very close to the lathe, but not coupled to the lathe. So now I can shoot from above. It is mounted on wheels, so I can move it. Oh, come on, that's too easy. How about you give us an S? An S? What are you talking about? Yeah, there is an S. Actually, there is two of them. So I created the base with 1x3 rectangular tubing, very sturdy, four Harbor Freight casters. But truly, the hardest part of this was creating this bracket in here, which was kind of, it had to be telescopic. I'll put a few shots in here of the different things that I thought. At first, I thought I could just take four angle pieces and put them on top of each other, but that didn't work very well. Then I took the four brackets, but I made two long ones and two small ones, welded them together to create this larger piece of a square tubing. It is an awful, awful job, but it works. I had to do a lot of sanding here to make sure that this thing would move. The bottom piece is much easier to make because it's open. There was no need to close it. At the end of the day, I only need one of them to be closed. This, of course, the one that is closed is the one that is going to have the screw so that I can fix the position. Right now, I'm using this wrench, but eventually I'll put a knob. It's kind of a early stages. The screw bolt was made on the lathe. And, everything was bolted together. Everything was welded together. And, the interface between the 2-inch square tubing to the base, I don't know, feels to me like it could break because it's literally just the tubing to the plate. So there is no like angles grabbing it. I may need to add something at some point in time. But right now it is working as it should be. So I don't know that I'm going to do much more with it. At the end of the day, this will allow me to make those shots that I couldn't do before. Well, there you have it, YouTubers. A camera non-tripod mounted on wheels and made out of steel. So now I can magnetically couple my camera flexible arm mount, but without it being coupled to the machine in question. I can also raise its height or lower it, allowing me to position the camera much better. I hope you like this video and you learn a few things on how you can improve your shooting if you're a maker and want to document your making. I want to thank you for tuning to my YouTube channel, and I'm going to see you on the next one. What could the answer be? Give me a beat.